a distinguished agricultural scientist, a dedicated teacher at graduate and postgraduate levels, and a devoted extension worker, Professor Kattagadihalli Math, who is 70 years old, spent nearly 30 years in various higher institutions of learning in agricultural extension, agricultural training, and agricultural research. His path-breaking achievement in the field of agriculture includes detailed studies on pests, insects, and extensive field trials on principal field crops such as paddy, jowar, cotton, chili, sugarcane, tobacco, groundnut, wheat, gram, safflower, etc., and evolving effective schedules of calendar-wise pest management practices for these crops, as a result of which both crop production as well as crop productivity have increased to such an extent as to yield more than three times than under the normal pest management practices. Professor Kattagadihalli Math is also famous for his unique and revolution and work in the field of arid horticulture in drought-prone Bijapur district of Karnataka, as a result of which the total economy of the entire district was changed. The outstanding merit of his work in his personal attention and survey of the field of agriculturists, giving them the spot training in horticulture and other employment avenues. Professor Kattagadihalli Math has participated in several state-level, national-level, and international seminars, symposia, workshop, and conferences. He has published 20 research papers and over 100 popular articles on agricultural and horticultural subjects. He is the recipient of several awards and honors, including the prestigious Karnataka State Rajyotsav Award in 1993. Professor Kattagadihalli Math is a unique combination of a scientist, a teacher, and an extension worker, so totally dedicated to the upliftment and improvement of the condition of the agriculturist, an achievement not attained even by big organizations with all their unlimited resources. He is verily an institution by himself.
This is an honor not only to me, but all those who are engaged in the crucial nation-building task of applying science and technology to agricultural development vis-à-vis rural development. After all, most of India is rural India, and agriculture is the backbone of life. What I have done in a modest way is to bring about a sustained development of agriculture and rural economy in that part of India, namely Karnataka, to which I belong, but my experiments have an all-India application. This seems an appropriate occasion to reflect on the fate of agriculture in India during the last 50 years. We are all celebrating the golden jubilee of our freedom. It is time to ask, how have these 50 years failed in the field of agriculture and rural development? I regret to say that even after half a century of independent India has not been able to overcome critical problems facing agriculture: underinvestment, low yields, low income and employment generation, and unsustainable agricultural development. To these must be added the gap between the technology and its productive application. We all know that India is predominantly a rural and agricultural country. Yet it is a tragic paradox that we have really no coherent and dynamic agriculture policy. Desperate ad hocism seems to characterize government intervention in agriculture. But we managed to enunciate an industrial policy as far back as in 1948. It was revised several times to deal with changing needs and resources of the country. We seem to forget that Indian industry itself cannot be sustained without a strong and dynamic agricultural foundation. The histories of countries considered industrially advanced today, such as the USA, have paid as much attention to agriculture as industry. Our plans began to take note of agriculture somewhat grudgingly only later. May I take this opportunity to appeal to the government to work out a coherent and forward-looking agrarian policy. We talk today a great deal about liberalization, no doubt. It is necessary if properly conceived to enable greater industrial growth. But far more crucial is the liberation of our vast masses from poverty, illiteracy, ill health, unemployment, and sheer under malnutrition. How can this liberation be achieved? There is no doubt this can be achieved only if we can achieve a breakthrough in agriculture and rural development. I suggest that the challenge today to Indian agriculture is to transform it into a cycle of high efficiency, optimal investment of capital and technology, high yields, high income, and high employment. But these crucial inputs and outputs must be conceptualized and operationalized in the context of broader framework of rural development. Our people fought and sacrificed for freedom, and there's no reason why they cannot be harnessed by our leadership to achieve all-round national development. India is singularly fortunate in its abundant natural resources, minerals and biodiversity, and human resources. We also possess great agro-climatic resources. There is a wealth of resources waiting to be developed, but without endangering the ecological balance. We need all this critical juncture in our national history to ask the troublesome but necessary question: what has gone wrong? Who is to blame? A critical examination of our record of our large failures and small successes should enable us to correct our policies and reorder our priorities. Jai Hind. Thank you.